Hello and welcome back. In the last lesson, we finished up in our user class by creating that set password function. And now that we have that user class all set up, what we want to do in this next lesson is wire this up to our router and allow us to actually register a user when someone navigates to the /register endpoint. And so we actually have instantiated a user in our router, and we've just done a few simple tests here. And at this stage, what I'm going to do is just delete everything in our try block over here. We will leave the user class that we've imported at the top. But what we want to do is kind of start from the beginning and begin to implement the logic that we need to successfully make this register service endpoint work end to end. All right, so to get started, what I want to do is I'm going to declare a constant here, and I'm going to use some object destructuring. I want to get the information that we need from the request that's going to come through here in order to create our user class. And this is going to be the first name, last name. We'll have the email address as well as the password. Okay, and this is going to come from the request, and there is an object on the request called body, and that's going to contain the information from the post that comes from the client, whoever's requesting the service. So at this point, all I want to do is a console.log. I want to see what's coming back in each of these values. And in order to do this, we're going to make sure our server is running. So in a terminal, just make sure that the server is running. And once it's up and running, we can go head over to Postman. We've used this for testing before. In the post to the register endpoint, we'll have a body set up, a JSON object with the keys. And I'm going to hit send here, and I'm just going to tell you ahead of time that this is going to fail. And I do know why that is, but you'll just see we do get an error. And as we can see here, the request is coming back as undefined. And so I'm just going to kill the server for now. And we're going to do some work in our API, specifically in the index.js file. And basically what we need to do is to configure the Express API to actually contain that body object that we are referencing on the request. And so in order to do this, we're just going to say app.use, and then we will say express.json. And we'll just invoke that with a parentheses. And if we hover over the JSON function over here, you'll see that it says it returns middleware that only passes JSON and only looks at requests when the content type header matches the type option. And so by setting this up and rerunning our server, once it's up and running, we'll go back to Postman. All right, so with our server listening, we can just hit send, and you'll see that it says sending requests, and it's just going to go in a hanging state. But we do see John Smith, john@test.com, and super secret. Those values are being dumped out here. So the reason why that is hanging is because we actually haven't sent a response back. I just wanted to make sure that we are actually receiving these values. And as you can see now, setting this express.json in the app.use allows us to successfully pull down the values from the request body. So that's looking good. Let's just do the rest of the work that we need to. Now that we've got a handle on some of the values that are coming through on the request, let's map them into our user class. So what we will do here is instantiate a new user class. We will say let user equals new user. And now that we have that class, we can start calling those functions that we set up in the last few lessons. At this point, I just want to kind of tie together two concepts that we've kind of been working on. So the strategy that I'm using here is I've set up this message variable here that will either contain a message that comes back from the validate function. And if a message does come back, that means there's something invalid in the input that we've put through. And otherwise, message will just remain false or null. And so what I'm going to use this in the router to kind of handle any errors that come along. And the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to declare a message here in our router, and I'm just going to initialize it to false. And then what I'll do is now for each first name, last name, email, password, etc., I'm going to use this pattern where I'm going to say let the message equal, then I'm going to call user.set first name, and then I'm going to pass in the first name into that function. And so what's happening here is if this first name is invalid, the message will have a string, Otherwise, if it is valid, it's going to be false. And then I can just do a conditional check. What I'll do is say, if message is true, that means there is an error. And then in this case, I want to return a 400 error back to the client who's making this request. In this case, we'll do a res.status, and then the status will be 400. We'll just send back a JSON object. And in here, we'll have an error key. We'll create an object. And we'll say code is 400. And then we'll just give a type so we know that what we're referring to. And this type will be a first name. And then the message that we'll pass through is the message that we get back from the validation. So let's try and run this and deliberately pass in a value that we know won't succeed here. And so if we pass in some type of value that's invalid, it should return a 400. And so let's head back over to Postman, and I'm just going to put in a value of null at first name here, and I'm going to send this through. And then you'll see we get back a 400 bad request. It says can't be blank, and so it's saying type here, first name can't be blank, and now we've got a strategy for handling invalid input that is coming through on our request. So that's kind of the pattern that I'm using over here. All we need to do now is implement this for each one of the last name, email, and password. So what we can do is, now that we have this message declared over here, we can just use the same variable over and over again for each one of these cases. So for the next one, we'll say user.setLastName. And then in here, we'll pass in the last name that's coming from the request. And in the same vein, we will check if there is a message that returns from here. We'll return a response back to the client. It'll be a 400, and then we'll do the same thing. We'll say, we'll send back some JSON and we'll give it an error. We'll say code is 400, type in this case will be last name, and we'll pass back the message that comes from our validate function. So let's just flip back and test this real quick. I'm going to revert our change in Postman. We'll have a valid first name. In this case, let's put null for last name. If we hit send here, you'll see we get back an error, but this time it's saying last name can't be blank. So we're making good headway. Let's just implement this same kind of strategy for setting the email. And so we can run through this really quickly. We can say a message equals user.setEmail. We'll pass through the email that we've got through coming on the request. We will check if there's a message. If there is a message, we will return a 400 with that JSON object containing the error and some additional information that we need. In this case, it'll be email, and then the last one, we'll just set up that message. All right, so I think you get the idea now. The last thing we need to do is just the same thing for the password. So in this case, what we need to do is remember that the setPassword function is an asynchronous function. So not to make the same mistake we did a while back, we'll just say await user.setPassword, and then we're going to pass in the password that's coming from the request. And if anything goes wrong here, or if it's in an invalid password and it doesn't match the constraints that we set, we will send back a 400. We'll set up our error, give it a code of 400. The type will be password, and then message will be the message that we get back. And then if we reach this point in our router, everything has gone well. Once we have our database connected, we want to actually save the user to the database. Before we do that, let's just do a console log of the user as it stands now. And so I'm just going to give us some more space in our terminal, restart our server, and we'll flip back over to our Postman, and we'll just set everything up. I'm going to hit send here, and then you'll see we're getting a hanging request because we actually haven't sent back a response. But if you take a closer look, you'll see that we have our user that's being console logged out here, and everything's looking good. We've got the created field, ID, the name object, email, as well as the security. So that's looking all good. What I am noticing here is we still have a console log that we've left behind here in the set password function. So I'm just going to delete that. All good so far. So at the moment, if we take a look at the user class, you'll see we've set up the skeleton for the save function. And so just for the sake of finishing this for now, what we're going to do is we can just pretend to save that user by calling the save function. The last thing, just to finish this off, is to send back a 200 if everything does go okay. So we'll do a res.status, and then we'll send back JSON. And in this case, we'll just send back the user that we have been setting up throughout this router. So let's go ahead and test that in Postman. I'm going to hit send here. You'll see we have that console log for the mock saving to the database, so that's fine. We get back our user object with all the fields that we've created. With all of this set up, we have successfully set up our register service in our API, and it's working end to end, with the one note that we haven't wired this up to a database. And so this is where I'm going to leave it for this section. What we'll do in the next section is think about how we're going to persist this data to disk. And once that's done, we can start moving on to setting up passport and local authentication. So well done on making it through this section. There was a lot going on, but hopefully by the end of it now, you have got a good idea of what we've been trying to do to set up the user model as well as the register route. I'm working with that user model to make sure that we're getting good data coming in from our request. And if everything succeeds, we're in a place where we can start saving this to the database. And so well done again on making it this far. I will see you in that next section. Cheers for now.